Welcome to Speak English Now podcast with your host, Georgiana, the podcast that will help you to speak English fluently with no grammar and no textbooks.
Hi, everyone. I'm Georgiana, founder of SpeakEnglishPodcast.com. My mission is to help you to speak English fluently. Today you will learn how to replace the word look in a sentence if you want to be more concise. I'll give you an example depending on the context. In the previous episodes, I gave several examples of terms or expressions that you may use instead of look. So make sure that you listen to the earlier episodes as well. By the way, if you are new here, visit my website to get the transcript of today's episode. Go to SpeakEnglishPodcast.com. If you're already familiar with the show, please share it with your friends and family. That would make me very happy. Tell your friends that my podcast is available everywhere on the internet. You can find it on my website and many podcast apps like Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, Facebook, SoundCloud, etc. Just look for Speak English Now with Georgiana and start learning English with me. We'll start with the word to scan. When we look over something quickly, we scan it. Let me explain. Imagine that you have to get out of the house and you're in a hurry. Surprise, surprise! You can't find your keys or your sunglasses. By the way, that never happened to me. I was just kidding. Unfortunately, that occurs to me quite often. So what do you do in this situation? You start looking for your keys or your sunglasses. Or you could say that you're scanning the room for your keys. Can you see? That's a more precise word to use in this situation. We might scan a room at a party to see if our friend is there. For example, I scanned the room to see if Mary was there. Or, I need to scan some diagrams for my PowerPoint presentation. Okay, let's use another word. For example, the word eye. The thing is that whenever we observe something, we use our eyes. So this word is quite straightforward. We use the word eye to express our interest in something. We might eye the candies on the table even though we don't want the extra sugar. I've been eyeing that cake for hours now, but I must resist, since I'm on a diet. Let's continue. Instead of using the word look, we could use examine. When we examine something, we inspect it closely. A doctor might examine your body to make sure that you're healthy. For example, whenever I got a cut, my mom examined it and then cleaned it for me. Let's continue with the word peer. When you can't see something completely because your vision is obstructed, we can say that you are peering at it. Let's hear some examples. The girl was jumping up and down, trying to peer out the window. George carefully peered inside the box. And the last word for today is witness. This word is similar to watch. It means that you saw something with your own eyes, usually an event. This word is often used in the field of criminal justice to say that someone witnessed a crime. Examples: a friend told me she witnessed a crime last night. Jane returned to the witness stand. Great! Let's continue with a point of view story. You will improve your English grammar without memorizing any rules. I'm going to tell you the same story twice, So pay attention to the different grammar points. It's a technique that I use in my courses. You just have to listen and enjoy the story. It's almost Christmas, and Emma and her 6-year-old daughter go shopping at the mall. As they walk, the little girl, who's holding her mother's hand, eyes a beautiful cake in a shop window. At the same time, Emma peers in a sophisticated fashion store. She immediately goes inside to examine the new seasonal dresses. After a few moments, Emma realizes that her daughter is no longer at her side. She quickly scans the store but can't find her daughter. Emma is so worried about not finding her daughter that she has an expression on her face as if she witnessed a crime. Finally, Emma finds her daughter in the bakery. She is inside, contemplating that delicious cake. So Emma and her daughter eat a big slice of that cake and enjoy their time together. Let's listen to the same story in the past tense. Just before Christmas, Emma and her 6-year-old daughter went shopping at the mall. As they walked, the little girl who was holding her mother's hand saw a beautiful cake in a shop window. At the same time, Emma eyed at a sophisticated fashion store. She immediately went inside to examine the new seasonal dresses. After a few moments, Emma realized her daughter was no longer at her side. She quickly scanned the store but couldn't find her daughter. Emma was so worried about not finding her daughter that she had an expression on her face as if she witnessed a crime. Finally, Emma found her daughter in the bakery. She was inside contemplating that delicious cake. So Emma and her daughter ate a big slice of that delicious cake to celebrate their time together. Okay, this is the end of this point of view story. Have you seen the power of the point of view technique? We have checked a lot of grammar by merely using the same story. It's very easy to compare the different structures because you compare them in parallel. If you want to get hours of audio with mini stories and point of view lessons, I'd like to recommend to you my fluency course. You can get it at fluencycourse.com. Well, that's it for today. Take care. Bye-bye.
Did you enjoy today's episode? Get the transcript now at speakenglishpodcast.com. speakenglishpodcast.com.